in this room, two of them are lit up by a nuclear power plant. And we can, you know, thank the engineers who come forward and create this power, and we should keep it around. The 6% that is noted in the EPA clean power plan, that they say it's because we have 6% at risk nuclear, 100% is at risk. All these power plants, they've been built since the 70s. 70s, they're going to shut down at least in the next 20 years. We can't just say, okay, we're going to give 6% to these nuclear power plants that we've had for a while and are providing the baseload power. What will happen is we'll end up shutting them down because of economics or political pressure, and we'll end up replacing them with natural gas. And what are we doing? We're adding CO2. So what I'm telling you is that this clean power plant is going to increase CO2 emissions if we do not do something about the way we're handling nuclear energy. What I would recommend, instead of making this such a complicated rule where you only look at fossil fuels and then add in a little bit of renewable for phase one or renewable for energy efficiencies and going from coal to natural gas combined cycle, you just look at the total CO2 emissions per state and megawatt hours produced in that state. And just look at that and say, well, we want to keep the same level and not look at just fossil fuels. Because if you look at the equation, I mean, I have some over here. It's pretty much the equation that says, oh, wait, you have to meet these goals by reducing either your emissions or increasing energy production from renewables and nuclear. Since you only give 6% to nuclear, that is a perverse incentive to say, okay, if we shut down a plant, we're only losing this like marginal percentage of its megawatt hours. And if we replace it with natural gas, then you're adding extra CO2, but you're adding more megawatt hours, and you could actually achieve your goal more easily by doing so, which would in effect increase CO2 emissions. So this way you're looking at the carbon intensity could actually be used by states to meet their goals by shutting down clean power plants like nuclear and replacing it with natural gas. And that brings me to another point. Natural gas, if you look at it over the past 6 years, its prices look like something like the stock market in the past 6 years. And do we really want to trust our electricity prices on something like that? So natural gas, yes, it's cheap and plentiful now, but how do we know it's going to be like that in the next 15 years when this plant's supposed to be met, that we're supposed to have our reductions met? So I think we should really take a step back. We don't need 70% capacity factor for natural gas. It's been historically a peaking power that we use for when we need it, like in the Arctic cyclone, whatever it's called. We weren't able to get power to these communities that needed it most. And with nuclear there, we had power. We did not have an issue with supplying places in the Northeast with nuclear energy. So I think we should really consider the way that this plan is being implemented. And I'll submit a formal comment with